So I'm talking about securing the crypto and the best practices. The goal of this presentation is to understand the high level, the different risk categories that you have when you hold crypto. And then when you understand and think it from this angle, then this helps you to protect yourselves against the risks and take these different things in consideration. I'm not presenting here any full list, but this gives you an idea how you could be approaching this situation. And this is something you should be thinking, especially if you are holding out of crypto, or maybe due to the bull market, your holdings has increased a lot in value, then you should check that are you protected against different types of risks. So what I have here outlines are three categories: human error, external threats, and unexpected events. The human errors kind of refer to more internal, you made a mistake thing. External threats is someone else doing something, and the unexpected is something that you might not have thought of, but then it happens and then you have that oops moment. So the human error might be, especially if you are new, just to the knowledge gap that you might have. You might not know what you should know, and then that leads to an error. Like maybe you don't understand how to back up your wallet, you don't understand how the private keys work, or you might even like just publicly copy paste your private key somewhere and then you lose your funds. So what you have to do is, first you have to get educated. Then second is losing password. You should take backups. If you only have one copy, then for one reason or another, you might lose it. Then there's another, a lot of errors happen due to typos and other mistakes when you're making wallet or making the backup. And you should always check how to back up a wallet and the crypto you are dealing with. Depending on the coins and protocols, they all have different methods. Different wallets have different methods. So you should double check that you actually have the backup, and that when you create a wallet that you have typed everything correctly. So you need to log in again and just check that it's all correct. And moving on to the next risk category, which are the external threats. These are of course hacks, and password management is here, but it plays a big part. So you never should store a password on your computer, especially on a text file that is unencrypted. You could be using a password manager that has a strong password, and that would give you sufficient protection. But the best way is always to store the passwords and the private keys offline and never have them to be connected on an online computer. So you could be using paper wallets, writing down the private key to a piece of paper and then storing the paper safely somewhere. Then we have the physical theft. And this is just that someone knows you got crypto and then they come and find it. And I would say the best protection is just not to talk too much about it. And if they don't, you have it, or you have a backup somewhere, then no one knows to come look for it. Then the third category is just to be careful, like depending on who's in the household, just to ensure that you save or store the backups and the keys in a proper place, so that not just the leading lady or your wife won't just come and throw them in the trash because he thinks that they were just a piece of paper that didn't seem too important. So ensure that you keep keep them somewhere where no accidents like that can happen. Then third one, are the kind of unexpected events. So your device could break down, could be your phone, your laptop, and a USB stick. So you don't be relying on a single device. So you have a backup, then put it to multiple places. If you have, for example, just one backup and it's a USB stick, the USB stick don't last forever, and just one day you might find out that it no longer is working. So you shouldn't be relying on a single device and take into account that everything can break and will break. Then especially if you are holding considerable amounts, you could be thinking of spreading around the different backups to few places. That even if you have multiple backups, but they are only in your house, and then your house bursts down, or some other hazard happens, then you would lose everything. This might not be that important if the amounts are not considerable. But if they are, then it's certainly a risk that you should cover. And then third one, a lot of people use so-called brain wallets, which mean that they just memorize the keys or the words to unlock the wallet. And this is all good and can be thought as very secure, but there's always the risk that you just forget. You might end up in an accident and then forget what the password was. Or, of course, also a death could result a loss of the money, which then you couldn't pass on to your relatives or friends. So the key question here to ask is that if there is a single point of failure, and what that could be, and then playing that game. As a summary, when you think of your crypto holding security, just think of a risk as a probability times the impact. So how likely would is it that something will happen, and then what would be that impact if it were to happen? And if that the risk is great, then you should take the measures to remove that risk or minimize it. So the more you hold, the more you need to plan.